we've created a portfolio of enjoyable and less risky tobacco and nicotine products. And we encourage adult smokers who would otherwise continue to smoke to switch completely to these alternatives. Now, there are three pillars that underpin this harm reduction strategy. Firstly, consumer choice. Smokers are most likely to switch to a product that delivers comparable satisfaction. Secondly, world-class science, to ensure that we are generating robust scientific evidence to demonstrate the reduced risk profile of our alternative products compared to cigarettes, and constantly innovating to meet consumers' preferences. And thirdly, standards and regulations, using our science to inform and evolve standards and regulations to give consumers, retailers, and policymakers confidence in our products. Now, product stewardship is at the forefront of this strategy, reviewing the materials and ingredients in our products, understanding the emission profiles, identifying and mitigating risks to protect consumers and our business. To advance tobacco harm reduction and reduce the health impact of our business, people must have confidence in our alternative tobacco and nicotine products. At BAT, we're committed to ensuring that our products are developed and manufactured responsibly. We have a rigorous framework for our product stewardship, reflecting our commitment to have products that meet consistently high quality and safety standards. Product stewardship guides both the development and testing of all of our products, ensuring we have a rigorous and systematic approach. Within our product stewardship activities, we conduct toxicological and safety risk assessments of the ingredients and materials proposed for all new and current tobacco and nicotine-containing products. We also conduct our own scientific research programs in support of our products, apply ongoing scientific and regulatory developments to our product assessments, and participate in scientific engagement with external stakeholders. Our toxicologists use published peer-reviewed literature and government databases of accepted information as a starting point. When additional needs for scientific information are identified, scientific studies are designed and conducted to fully assess new and current products. Our vapor, tobacco heating products, and nicotine pouches are first stewarded at an ingredient level, carefully assessing each ingredient and material that is used in the product. For vaping products, ingredients to be included in e-liquids must be, at minimum, food grade, with nicotine being pharmaceutical grade. Similarly, for tobacco heating products, all non-tobacco ingredients must be at minimum food grade or food contact grade. Beyond toxicological assessments of ingredients and materials, device safety is also carefully assessed during product development. Prototypes and final products are tested against and must pass several international safety standards. Our nicotine pouches are also first stewarded at an ingredient and material level. Each ingredient and material must be at minimum food grade, and the nicotine must be pharmaceutical grade. Our scientists evaluated the effect of 9 flavoured BAT e-liquids on human lung cells. And this study demonstrated that the tested e-liquid flavours do not meaningfully increase the measured toxicological impact of the respective e-cigarette aerosols when compared to cigarette smoke. Now, it's important to note that these findings were derived from commercial products that have already undergone rigorous product stewardship and compliance checks with ingredient inclusion and exclusion criteria based on globally recognised risk assessment approaches. We believe similar manufacturing and safety standards should be formally introduced and required for vaping products across the industry.